السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. In the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most beneficent. How are you students? Hope all of you are fine. Alhamdulillah. Today is our topic about factorization. The factorization is your previous topic you did in class 7. Most of the things that you have already done in the previous classes, only we give the review of that one. And the questions are changed. Method and formula are the same. Only the question, there is a variation in your question. Yes, before starting the exercise, let us recall the definition of the factorization. Factors. What are factors? You find the factors, prime factors of the different number in class 6, 96, 97, 6, 2, 3. Suppose we are finding the factor of 6. The factor of 6 are 1 multiply 6 and 2 multiply by 3. The factors of an expression are the expressions whose product is the given expression. Whose product is the given expression means I give you the example that 6 is equal to 2 multiply by 3. So product 2 multiply by 3 is the given expression is equal to 6. Factors of an expression are the expressions whose product is the given expression. But in this exercise, we find the factors of expression, not the numbers. But I give you the example only of numbers. That product of the expression means if you have 6 and you convert it to multiply by 3. Then factorization, because when you, if you know the meaning of the factor, then you can find the factorization. The process of expressing the given expression as a product of its factors is called factorization. And there are many types of factorization. And in some questions, only three numbers are given or two given. We took the common factor from it. Then four terms are given. We make the pair of them. And then we took common from it. Then by using formulas, a plus b whole square, a minus b whole square, a square minus b square. All these formulas and terms, they are not new for you. You have already know about it. The first type in exercise 6.2, the first type is a general form, ka plus kb plus kc. K mean any constant term. A, b, c will be the variables. I give you the example. We have this type of question 2x minus 4y plus 3z. And when you compare this with the type KA plus KB plus KC, it means that three or two terms are given to you and you make the factor of each term and then we will take the common from it. Yes, exercise 6.2. Factorize the following. There are 16 questions in the exercise. I done some question for you and the remaining will be your homework. I paste the whole exercise because it will be easy to you to see the question of your homework because some students don't have the books. Factorize the following. Easiest exercise of this chapter. 3x minus 9y. 3x minus 9y. 3x means 3 into x. This dot doesn't mean that it is decimal. It means that the product 3 into x. Minus, I make the factor of 9. 3 into 3 into y. Now clearly you see that 3 is common in both the term. 3 is with x and also 3 is with y. So we take 3 common. No variable is common. Only the constant term 3 is common. So we took 3 common. The first term, we take 3, so only x is left over there. Then after this minus sign, and we take 1, 3 common from the second term, so 3y is left over there. And you mentioned that 3 is a common factor in each term. You must mention that which term you take common from the terms. So only we took 3x minus 3y. And our answer is complete. You are looking very happy that how much short this question is. Yes. Come to the next question. 6AB minus 14AC. 6AB minus 14AC. So make the factor of 6 and also the factor of 14. 6, the factor of 6 are 2 into 3 and 14, 2 into 7. Now clearly we can see that 2 is common in both terms. And which variable? A. 2a is common in each term. When we took 2a common from the first one, what will be left there? 3 is left and b is left. Then minus sign, we take 2a common, 7 is left and c is left. Which term we take common from it? 2a. The remaining are 3b minus 7c. And I mentioned there 2a is common in each term. Finish. Come to the next question. Question number 4. 3m3np minus 6m square n. Now in the first term there are 3m and 1n, 1p. In the second term 2m are given and there is no p. But you will make the factor of the constant term. The factor of 3 is 3 only. And the factor of 6 will be 2 into 3. So we split all the terms. We split also the powers. M raised to the power 3 means you write M 3 times. 3 into M into M into M. Then 1N. Then 1P. Minus the factor of 6 are 2 into 3. M. M and N. Now you see which term is common? 3. And then how many M? 2 M's are there. M into M, 2 M's are there. So I took common 3 into M from each term. So first term, which terms will be left? Which number will be left there? M, N, and P. Because we take 2m common and also 3. Come to the second term. 2 is left and 1n is left. Because you already take 2m common. So m and p minus 2n. 3m square and m and p minus 2n. This is our required answer. And I mentioned there that 3m square is a common term. Yes, the next question. 17x square y square minus 51. The factor of 17 will be only 17 into 1. But the factors of 51 are 17 into 3. 17 into 3. See the next step. 17 into x square minus 17 into 3. Which term is common? Only 17 is common over there. Only 17. No variable is there because 51 is only the term. No variable is with it. So we take 17 common. X square, y square. And in the next term, minus 3 is left there. 17 is a common term. Our answer is 17 into x square, y square minus 3. Some students are jumping that how much easy exercise is this. No need to see the screen. Yes? Give the attention to the question. Come to the next question. Question number 9. X cube y minus x square y plus xy square. I done all the variety of question for you, which are different from each other. And you see that although the method is same, but the power, the variables, the terms are different from each other. Now x cube y, it means x is 3 times. So we write x into x into x into y. Then x 2 times, x into x. Then y 2 times, y into y. You see, I split all the powers in the first step. Then be careful by taking the common terms. You see that x, y is common. Only x, y is common in all the terms. When we take x, y common, how many terms are left in the first? 2x. X into x. I mean 2x are left there. Then in the next, minus x, and in the last only y is left there. So our answer is xy into x square minus x plus y. We convert in all the expression the product of two expression. You see, your answer is in the form of product of two expression. This is the definition of factorization, that when we convert every expression in the product of two factors. Yes, come to the 12th question. 4x cube y square minus 8xy plus 4xy cube. Each term you see the coefficient, and if we need, we split it. Now we can split 8 because 4 and 4, we have the factor of 4, 2 into 2. But also 8 is in the table of 4, so no need to split 4, only we split x. Split 8 also. 4 into x cube, so I write 3x, then y square, 2y. Then minus, the factors of 8 are 2 into 4x into y plus, no need to convert 4. 4 into x into y into y into y because 3 y's are there. Now in each term, 4 is common, then x is common, then y is common. So we took 4xy common. See carefully in the first term, how many x are left there? You take 1x common and 1y. 2x are left there and 1y is left there. Then in the second term, we already take 4xy common. Only 2 is left there, minus 2. And in the third term, only 2y's are left. We took common f4xy. So our required answer is 4xy into x square y minus 2 plus y square. Come to the next question. 15. 77x square y minus 33xy square minus 55x square y square. Split 77. 11 into 7. X square mean x into y minus again 33. 11 into 3. 1x and y square mean we write 2y there, y into y. Minus 55 means 11 into 5, x into y into y. Now clearly y is common. How many x? 1x. How many y's? 1y. 11xy is common. The first term 7 is left, x is left. Then next 3 is left, y is left. And in the last term 5 is left, 1x and 1y is left there. 11xy, 7x minus 3y minus 5xy. The last question is 5xy plus 10x4 plus 15x cube. The lowest power of x is 3 in this question. We also split 10 and 15 because no need to write 5 as 5 into 1. 5 and there are x as a power 5, so I write 5 times x plus 10, 5 into 2. x4 means we write 4 times x plus 15, 5 into 3. X cube, 3 times x, x into x into x. Be careful when you are taking common terms, especially in the variables. 5 is common in the constant term or in the coefficients. And how many x? x3. I told you, you see in the question, the lowest power of the variable, it means that the lowest power of the variable will be common in all the terms. X cube. Now in the first, 2x are left, then plus 2 into 1x is left, and at the end only 3 is left there. So after taking 5x cube common, x square plus 2x plus 3 is left. You enjoy this exercise. This is very, very easy. The next exercise is same that we have done 6.2. There are three or two terms in 6.2. Now we have four terms in each question. In each question, we have four terms. First, we make the partner of two terms. Then we take common. The same procedure that we have done in 6.2. And at the end, again, we take common. It means that in these questions, we take two times common the terms. And the general form of this type is AC plus AD plus BC plus BD. That I told you we have four terms. And I give the example, like these type of questions, we have 3x plus 6x plus 3c plus c squared. Now come to the exercise, and we have done this in class 7, 8.6 exercise. I think you remember this. Yes, 14 questions are given to you. And you see that in each question, four terms are given. Either the signs are different, positive and negative. But in each question, four terms are given to us. We make the partner to them, and then we take common. Now come to the questions. Factorize the following. Again, I'm repeating the definition of the factorization. The factorization is the process in which we convert the expression in the product of two expressions. This is called factorization. Yes, question number two. 2ab minus 6bc minus a plus 3c plus 3c. Four terms are given. A 2ab minus 6bc minus a plus 3c. We make the partners. For the partners, you see I draw the round brackets, parentheses. 2ab minus 6bc, we closed in these two terms in the first bracket, and the remaining two terms minus a plus 3 in the other bracket. Now in the brackets, you factorize the term. 2ab means 2 into a into b minus, we split 6, 2 into 3 and also b into c. Then plus a means minus a into 1. The factor of a will be a into 1. And 3c, we can write 3c plus 3 into c into 1. Now in the first bracket, 2b is common. In the first bracket, 2b. 2b is common, you take 2b, and within the parentheses, which terms are left there? A minus 3c. A minus 3c, because we have take 2b common. Come to the next bracket. Now there is also negative sign. So we take the negative sign common. We take minus and 1 is common in these two terms. We take minus 1 common. And when you take negative sign from any bracket, the sign of that bracket will be changed. The sign of 3 will convert into minus. Within the bracket, a minus 3c. Now again, you see a minus 3 is common. A minus 3c, a minus 3c. You see within the bracket, both terms are same. Also the sign, also the coefficient, and also the powers of the variable. They are same, a minus 3c. And in all the questions, it is necessary that within the brackets, the variable, the power, the sign are equal, are same. Then we can take a minus 3c common because both brackets are same. When we take a minus 3c common, which terms are left there? 2b minus 1. And there will be no sign within two brackets. No sign, because we convert in the product, and product means multiplication. A minus 3c into 2b minus 1. You see that there is no sign, positive and negative, in between the brackets. So 2ab minus 6bc minus a plus 3c, when we find the factor of this expression, the answer become a minus 3c into 2b minus 1. Is it clear? Okay, come to the next question. Question number 4. The question is,
एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस 5x माइनस 2x माइनस 10. अगेन वी मेक द पार्टनर फर्स्ट टू टर्म्स एंड लास्ट टू टर्म्स. एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस 5x वी इनक्लोज दिस इन वन ब्रैकेट एंड माइनस 2x माइनस 10 वी इनक्लोज दिस एक्सप्रेशन इन द सेकेंड वन. स्प्लिट द टर्म्स. x square mean x into x and 5x mean 5 into x. Again come to the next bracket. 2x mean 2 into x and 10, 2 into 5. In the first bracket, which terms are common? Only x. We take x common, x plus 5. Within the bracket, x plus 5 is left. And in the second bracket, 2 is common. And also minus sign is common. You see there are two minus signs, so we take negative sign common. And I told you that when we take negative sign common, what happened? The sign within the brackets will be changed. Positive convert into negative and negative convert into positive. And always the sign within the two brackets will be same. In the first bracket x plus 5, it must be x plus 5 in the second bracket. Now you see x plus 5 is common. X plus 5 we take common, and which terms are left there? X minus 2. And again there is no sign in between the brackets. X plus 5 into x minus 2. So again we convert the expression x square plus 5x minus 2x minus 10 in the product of two linear expressions. X plus 5 into x minus 2. The next question is 6. X square plus 3x minus 4x minus 12. The same sign that we use in the previous question. X square plus 3x minus 4x minus 12. Make the partner first two terms within one bracket and the other two terms in the second one. X square plus 3x and plus minus 4x minus 12. Write the factor of x square, x into x, 3x, 3 into x, 4x, 4 into x, 12, 3 into 4. No need to write 4, 2 into 2 and then 12, 2 into 2 into 3. Directly we can convert 12 in the form of 3 into 4 because already 4 is there. Now in the first bracket, x is common. X plus 3 is left there, and again minus 4. We can take minus 4 common, and the next bracket is x plus 3. Both bracket have the same variable, have the same sign, have the same constant term. So we take x plus 3 common and x minus 4 are the remaining terms which we enclosed in the other bracket. So the factor of x square plus 3x minus 4 minus 12 is equal to x plus 3 into x minus 4. Come to question number 8. You see girls, students, all the expressions are quadratic. Only the formation of the signs are changed. In the previous questions, plus, plus and then minus is given. Then first plus sign is given, then minus, and then minus is given. And now first two negative sign and the last one is the positive one. Now again, the procedure is same. Only the game of sign. First we enclose two numbers, first two term within the first bracket, x square minus 8x, plus within the second bracket we write minus 4x plus 32. Split x, x into x, and again 8x, 8 into x. Minus 4x, minus 4 into x, 32, 4 into 8. Simply from the first bracket, x is common. No change of sign. No need to take any negative sign common in the first bracket. We write x minus 8. But in the second bracket, you see, there is negative sign with the first term, minus 4. So it is necessary if the sign is negative with the first term, we take negative sign common. Minus 4 common, the left is x minus 8. Both brackets have the same terms, same sign, same variable, same constant term. X minus 8 common, Left of the terms are x minus 4. So we convert x square minus 8x minus 4x plus 32 in the factor of x minus 8 into x minus 4. Yes, the next question. The signs are almost same that we have done in the previous question. Only the constant, the variables are changed here. The signs are same. The procedure will be same. Enclose, make the partners two terms. Enclose them within the brackets. We have two brackets there. We split x square, 13x, 2x and 26 in the terms of factor. In the first term, in the first bracket, we see that x is common. X minus 3 is 13 is remaining. Then minus 2x, we take common. Minus 2 only we take common. X minus 13. By mistake, I write there 2x. Only we take 2 common there. X minus 13 is left there. Then x minus 13 and x minus 13, they both are same. And x minus 2 is left there. So we convert x square minus 13x minus 2x plus 26 in the form of x minus 13 into x minus 2. This question is little bit different from the previous question, but this make your answer easy. Your step, already first step have done, only we take the second, we do the second step over there. Y into y minus a minus b into y minus a. Y minus a is common in both. So we take y minus a common, the remaining term is y minus b. Alas. Only in first step, one step, your answer is completed. You have done question 12. How much easy is this question? We already first step is given. We do the second step that we have done in the previous question. They already make the partner, they take common, they take the negative sign common. Only we make the partners over there. Y minus A into Y minus E. They both are neighbors of each other. Come to question 14. Same. AB, X plus Y, X plus Y. You see that X plus Y is common. Already they make our work easy. They make the partner, they took common, and they left only one step for us. And what that step is? We take x plus y common from the both term, and ab plus cd is left there. And we mentioned that x, y is common in each term. How much easy today lesson? 6.2 and 6.3. Very, very easy exercises of this chapter. We have done only these two types. In the next exercise, we will use the a plus b whole square, a minus b, and then gradually we use the formulas in each exercise. Yes, come to the homework. Your homework is exercise 6.2. I mentioned the questions over there. 2, 5, 7, 8, 10, 11, 13, 14, and then exercise 6.3. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13. These exercises are too much easy that you send me the work within, I think, 10 minutes or 15, not more than this. And better do the your homework and classwork the same that I show you in my lecture. You will use the color pen also, but don't use red and green pen. You write the question with black and do the answer with blue, but you can mention the common terms, the statement with different colors. I hope, inshallah, you will follow my instruction. Allah Hafiz, we will meet again, inshallah.